In this question, it says, in the given circuit diagram, the currents I1, I4 and I5 are flowing as shown. These values are given in the circuit. We are required to calculate the current I2, I3 and I6. So that can be quickly obtained by using Kirchhoff's current law. Here we can write, in the circuit shown, using KCL, we have, in this case, if we write KCL at junction R, here we get I1 plus I2 is equals to I4. So if I1 plus I2 is I4, here we can calculate the value of I2, which is I4 minus I1. And here you can see the value we are getting, I4 is 0.8 ampere. Minus of I1 is minus 0.3, then this minus 0.3 ampere, that gives us I2 is equals to 1.1 ampere. And the value of I2 we have got as 1.1 ampere. Now if we calculate the value of I3, that can be obtained by using KCL at junction S. Because I4 is given, I5 is given, that we can calculate I3 from using KCL at junction S, which gives I1 is equals to I3 plus I5. So here the value of I3 we are getting is I1 minus I5. So here if we substitute the values of I1 and I5, the value of I1 is minus 0.3 ampere, minus here the value of I5 we are getting is, I5 is given to us as 0.4 ampere, minus 0.4 ampere. If we can check, the value we are getting is slightly different than the values given here. This I4 is equals to I3 plus I5, so this I4 minus I5. So I4 we are having 0.8 ampere minus 0.4 ampere, so this is giving us 0.4 ampere. So this is the value we are getting for I3. So with the values of I2 and I3, here we can see in this question the answer can be chosen as option A, because only in option A I2 and I3 values are appropriately matching. However, we can calculate the value of I6 also. So here if we apply the KCL at Q directly, you can write, and we can use I6 is equals to I5, because there is a single branch, so there can never be different currents. The value of I5 is 0.4 ampere. So all the three currents we obtained, 1.1, 0.4 and 0.4. So answer matches here with the option A.